गुड इवनिंग जेंटलमैन। सो टॉपिक फॉर टुडेज लेक्चर इट इज़ द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन इंडिया एंड इसराइल। इंडिया एंड इसराइल बिगेन इट्स फॉर्मल डिप्लोमेटिक रिलेशनशिप फ्रॉम 1992 एंड लास्ट ईयर इट हैज़ कम्प्लीटेड द 28th ईयर ऑफ इट्स डिप्लोमेटिक रिलेशनशिप। एंड बिफोर दैट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन इंडिया एंड इसराइल वर नॉट सो गुड एज द इसराइल वॉज इन अ कोल्ड वॉर सॉर्ट ऑफ सिचुएशन विद पैलेस्टीन एंड इंडिया वॉज एग्रेसिवली एंड क्वाइट prominently was supporting Palestine, but however, seeing the advancement and the technology development in the Israel, gradually India shifted its diplomatic relation toward the Israel, and right now Israel and India has a very good ties, not only the military and the defense, but also on the bilateral trade agreement and also for the agriculture and between the intelligence agency. So I would, when I talk about the very first one and the prominent one, the defense ties and defense deal between India and Israel, then India and Israel are India is the largest buyer of defense of Israeli defense system in the world. Beside Israel is the second biggest supplier to the India in the term of defense equipment after the Russia. The first defense deal that took place between India and Israel was the Barak one. And another important and the prominent one was Falcon AWACS. Besides this, there have been so many military exercises between the two nations. Israel had also not only supplied with so many military equipments and drones, but had also upgraded the existing technology of the military defense system of India. Beside this defense, India and Israel also share a very good amount of relationship in the development of the agriculture of both the nation, and as we know that Israel is very prominent in using the technology, and right now the major concern for India is the cyber security. As few years earlier we would have heard about the ransomware attack which were done in the different part of the country. So after that, the India was became very proactive and was eager in order to develop its defense system for the cyber security, so that any of the foreign hackers could not hack our important institutional data. And for this, India needs the support of Israel, because Israel, as we know that Israel has the largest and the most effective defense cyber attack setup. So this would be certainly helpful for our country. Besides this, India and Israel are continuously negotiating for the free trade agreement, and if they are able to negotiate the free trade agreement, it would be beneficial for both the countries, as India serves a large market for Israel, and also the technology of the Israel India could use the resources. So this way, thank you.